First of all, he put God first. First and foremost, he put God first in his life. Then second, hallelujah, preacher, see how. Secondly, then he put his family business straight. Somebody shall say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You can pray the prayer of Jezebel all your life, but if God don't consider your country to be honorable to your loved one.
All right. Come on with it.
Now what the Bible says,
God
granted Jezebel prayer request to him because he granted Jezebel to be what? Honorable.
Yes.
Are you honorable to your loved one? The one God has blessed you with. Do you honor the blessing God gave you?
Yes.
Jesus set the example for us that when he presented the bread and the fish to God, and God blessed it and he multiplied.
Yes.
And after he had done feeding all the 5,000 plus, what did he tell his disciples? Pick up the crumbs because they are also blessed.
Right.
Respect what God blessed you with. Hallelujah. Because it is a privilege. Tell neighbor, it's a privilege. It is a privilege to live in the house you live in today. It is a privilege to drive the car you're driving today. It is a privilege to have the air that you are breathing today. It is a privilege that you are standing upon your 2 feet. It is a privilege that you're able to rise in the morning and feel the cold breeze on your skin. Come on, it's a privilege that you rise in the morning and hear the cry or the happy joy of your children all around you. It is a privilege. Somebody shout,
it's a privilege.
Isn't that all right?
Yes. Yes, sir.
And because if you look around, you're going to find out that there are some folks that on the same journey with you that don't have such a privilege.
That's right. That's right.
There are people that you know in the hospital.
Yeah.
There are people that you know on the ground.
Is that
right? People that you knew that have gone on the ground.
Yeah.
People that you know that live in your neighborhood that want to walk in your shoes.
Yes, yes.
So you have to respect what God has blessed you with.
Yeah. Amen.
To have joy and peace. Because you want for the prosperity of God to make you happy. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Does that make sense at all? You want the prosperity of God in your life to bring joy to you.
Yes.
To bring peace to you.
Yes.
To come on and to bring security to you, to bring confidence to you. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. To make you feel that you have a backbone to stand.
Yes, yes.
Backbone to stand on your own. Because mama not going to be there all the days of your life. Daddy not going to be there all the days of your life. When that mission is over, they will be gone. But you will want to have a backbone to stand on. There's a reason that God has been bringing me prosperity in my life.
Hallelujah.
To understand, to have wisdom, to have knowledge, and to have understanding.
Yes.
Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There comes a time that the girls have to become a woman or the boys have to be the man.
That's right.
Amen. So true.
Does that make sense at all?
Yes. Yes.
Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you're going to talk the talk, then walk the walk.
Yes.
Walk the walk, because the so-called friend that we think they have our back, there's something wrong happening. There's something negative happening.
Okay.
The longer they stay with you is about a week.
Come on now.
Preach.
Longer they stay with you. But when God starts to bless you with your own foundation, with your own circle of family, pray to God that He make your circle stronger.
Yes.
Then your family circle be stronger. That nothing will come between you and your family to break your circle apart. The circle got to be stronger. Because as the circle increase, it has to be stronger in wisdom. As the circle increase, it got to be strong in knowledge. As the circle increase, it got to be strong in understanding to care for one another.
Yes, Lord.
Does that make any sense at all? Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, do not just enjoy prosperity, but let the prosperity come with peace, joy, and happiness.
Yes.
The blessing of God makes one rich and the eye no sorrow.
No sorrow.
I've seen some rich folks.
Thank you.
That are frowning every day.
Amen.
It can break your heart every day.
Jesus.
pressurizing every day. Because while they bring the finances in, because you pay the bills so you can treat your loved one any kind of way. Then you are messing with your own peace. You are messing with your own joy. There's a saying, if mama is not happy, nobody else is happy. Can I repeat that once again? There's a saying, if mama is not happy in the home, the house is not happy. Tell the Lord, I thank you. So when you ask God for prosperity, when God starts to bless you with prosperity, position yourself that you will contribute to your joy. Position yourself to contribute to your happiness. Position yourself to contribute to your peace in the home. Somebody shall say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh yes. God can give you the bike, but he will not train you how to ride it.
All right.
You better learn how to ride the bike for yourself. Because other than that, you will be like my granddaughter or car will be sitting.
All right.
She not expect me. I will give her the car. She don't expect me to go teach her how to drive. Somebody shall say, praise the Lord. Somebody say, glory to God. Say, Lord, I thank you. So, yeah, it's good to prosper. But are you enjoying the pleasure that goes with the prosperity? Are you enjoying the peace that goes with the prosperity? Are you enjoying, come on now, somebody shall say, hallelujah. Are you